And it's time to tell the Palestinians, abandon your fantasy of destroying Israel. Abandon the fantasy that you will conquer Jerusalem.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is facing battles on many fronts. In the Golan Heights, he's dealing with new threats from Iranian forces in Syria. He's also facing international condemnation from the killing of Palestinians at the Gaza border. We traveled to Jerusalem to ask him how his administration is responding.
That's the Iranian drone we shot down. It's got a wing here, fixed wing here.
So this was an Iranian drone sent over Golan Heights. Right. You shot it down. They then sent missiles and artillery to attack right. you on the Golan Heights, and then you... Right. So this was the start of everything.
Right that was here. It. That was this it. Was and you see it. The center was blown up by our interception, but these are the parts that come from the center. And I think it's the first time that we're showing this.
Yeah, it's the first time.
Yeah.
How do you know it was 100% Iranian?
We know for sure because this is an Iranian drone. You can see pictures of this drone, by the way, in Iran itself. We also have, obviously, the intelligence
right.
that we were aware that they were doing this. They had explosives in this drone, too.
You have intelligence that the Revolutionary Guards are moving in other weapons.
Right.
What happens? Does this escalate?
I hope not, because I hope they'll get the message that we're not going to let them do it.
The day before our meeting, the U.S. officially moved its embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, setting off a massive protest in the Gaza Strip that ended with at least 60 Palestinians dead.
Today was a historic day. The embassy opened here in Jerusalem, but yet at the same time, there were unprecedented riots in Gaza.
Not riots.
Or
deliberate infiltration attempt paid and organized by Hamas.
For 20 years, they didn't open the embassy because they were afraid of violence. And now the embassy was opened and there was violence. So what do you say to the criticism that's coming from around the world?
I think that President Trump did a very important thing. He not only kept his promises and the promises of successive American presidents, he also recognized a simple reality. You're sitting now in the government office of the Israeli government in Jerusalem. The Prime Minister's office is right here in Jerusalem. The Israeli government, the seat of Israel's government, is in Jerusalem, which is its capital. And it's been the capital of the Jewish people only for 3,000 years. And I think that's the key, ultimately, to peace. Because a peace that's based on lies will crash on the rocks of Middle East realities.
Mm.
And it's time to tell the Palestinians, abandon your fantasy of destroying Israel. Abandon the fantasy that you will conquer Jerusalem. Abandon the fantasy that says Israel will disappear. It will not.
But didn't they not do it for 20 years because they didn't want it to preempt a peace process, so i.e. in a negotiation where, because Palestine believes that it's a capital too, so it's a dual capital or what have you, so they didn't want to say, well, in case this is a negotiating block, we're taking it off the table.
Well, I think what he took off the table is the fact that Jerusalem is Israel's capital. He didn't define exactly, where the line would be in Jerusalem, but he said it's very clear that this part, where we're sitting now, is going to remain Israel's capital. He's right.
The Prime Minister's spokesman was just as adamant that actually it's the Israelis whose lives are in danger.
A genocidal terrorist organization that long before any embassy
Hamas.
Was spoken about, Hamas, was calling to kill every single Jew. We can't afford to just say, well, that's hyperbole. Maybe they don't mean it. The head of Hamas, Yahya Sinwar, said, سَنَقْتَلَعَ الْحُدُودُ وَسَنَقْتَلَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ. We will tear down the border and we will tear out their hearts. I take him at his word. I think he's trying to tear down the border because he's trying to destroy Israel.
But tanks against rocks is not a fair fight.
Well, long before any tank was used, we used rad dispersal methods. I'll tell you what makes it so hard to not hit anybody who isn't involved. It's the fact that they're shooting from behind kids. That's why they're burning tires to put up a smoke screen to make it harder to see who's a civilian and who's an armed combatant. But Hamas has no concern whatsoever for their people. We could be wonderful allies with Palestinians living in Gaza. Why not? The people are not the problem. The regime is the problem.